The other company that we're going to be talking about is Muthoot Finance, which has posted steady earnings for the quarter gone by. My colleague Shefali is here to talk a little bit more about the earnings with the management. Shefali.
Muthoot posted very good set of earnings this time around, and as it is, gold finance companies have been doing pretty well. So I spoke to Mr. George Alexander Muthoot, Managing Director at Muthoot Finance. So hi, a very warm welcome to the show. So could you walk us through some more highlights of the quarter? How did the margins and the disbursements pan out?
Thank you. And as you said, this year, as well as this quarter, has been good for us. In the gold loan sector, we have grown by 1,700 crores in this quarter alone. And today, our gold loan AUM has reached plus of 33,000 crores. That's a record number. And all the other subsidiaries also put together, we have reached 38,500 crores. That's also a substantial increase of 20% compared to last year. The profit, the standalone profit has reached about 1,970 crores and the consolidated profit about 2,100 crores. These are also record numbers as far as the company is concerned. And the other divisions has also done well. Probably we saw a little slowdown in the home finance because it was also a conscious decision taken by us because of the turmoil in the housing finance sector with the ILFS crisis and also some of the other home finance companies also facing problems. And also coupled with that, some of the problems have been transferred to the builders also. So we have gone slow on the disbursals in the home loan sector. We had wanted to reach about 2,500 crores of AUM for the home finance, but we ended up with 2,100 only. Probably next year, this year we see good potential, good opportunity in the home finance because we expect the all the problems, etc. in the home finance to be behind us today, and we should see better growth in the coming year. We expect to grow the AUM by about 1,000 plus crores in home finance this year.
So let's talk about your gold loan business. For that particular segment, your profit has grown for the full year has grown just by about 11%. And that is a concern. Your core business is growing at a nominal pace. So what is the outlook for FY20?
See, as far as gold loan business is concerned, that's our core business. That's our bread and butter. As of date, 88% of our business is from the gold loan. So we have targeted a business of maybe 15% plus just for the gold loan business. It also depends on the economic activities. If the economic activities pick up and there is no disruptions in the market, political or economic disruptions in the market, we should see a 15% plus growth in the gold loan sector. Last year, we had grown by 18%. So this year, minimum growth of 15% is what we expect. If things are okay, if credit demand also picks up, probably we can look at a higher number also, as far as the AUM growth is concerned for the gold loan business.
So your ticket size in the gold loan business has gone up by roughly around 4,000 rupees. Any particular reason for that, or is that normal business?
It's about 38,000, it has gone to 41,000. It is just a normal increase. Probably our gold loan customers are getting a little more prosperous.
Sir, I want to go back to the home loan business. You said that you've decided to go a bit slow because of the turmoil in the industry at a sector level. So I want to understand that you as a standalone entity, how does the entire turmoil impact you?
To put things a little more in perspective, Muthoot Home Finance, we give only affordable houses and the average ticket size is 10 lakhs only. And we give to these affordable sections. We don't do any builder finance. We don't do any LAP, pure and simple, fully home finance to home buyers only. So, but what is happening is some of our customers take loans from partly built up properties or properties which are being built by builders. If there is a problem with the builder, he may not be able to complete the project. So that is where the problem happens, because if we finance a genuine home loan buyer and he goes and gets himself trapped with a probably a unreliable builder, then he has a problem, and which we wouldn't like to happen. So that is why we are little choosy on where our customers take their home loans. Customers may be good, they are genuine, but suppose he falls into the trap of a wrong builder, then he has a problem, which definitely will affect us also. That is why we have been little careful in the last 6 months. From past October, we have been choosy in where, which area, which type of not customers though, which type of builders, etc., are taking being used by our customers. So we are little choosy. That is why our AUM is not grown. So today we have 1,900 crores of AUM. We would like it to grow by about 800 to 900 crores next year. So to that extent, we are now ramping our things and probably being a little more cautious in the selection of our, not the borrowers though, projects where our borrowers are investing.
Makes sense, sir. So a word about the microfinance business that's also been a focus area for you. How much growth are you targeting in the segment going forward, and what are the trends that have been shaping up lately?
Yeah, the microfinance, which is done by a subsidiary, which is Bellstar, it is a 70% subsidiary of Muthoot. So we recently, there was a private equity investor also come in there. He has invested 10%. So we have 70%. And the earlier promoters have 20%. That is where we stand. That is doing extremely well. The PAR, the profit at risk, is quite low compared to any other microfinance. And we are quite happy with that performance, and probably they would like to grow their book by 600 to 700 crores next year. They have about 2,100 crores of portfolio. They will grow about 700 crores next year. It has also done extremely well, and it is well capitalized today because the PE investor has brought in money. We have also put in money. So we see a lot of prospects for that company, which is called Bellstar Finance. Works out of Chennai and has branches all over the country.
Sir, a bit more about the liquidity crisis. You have been in a relatively better position because of your positive asset liability position, and also because of the fact that you get gold as a collateral for the loans that you give. So when you go to the market to raise money now, do you get the benefit in the form of cheaper cost of funds?
So you are right. If I talk to my CFO, he always says that all the banks, everybody is very keen to finance us, because as you said, there is absolutely no ALM mismatch, because our loans are very short term. We can easily raise money at will. And secondly, our collaterals are gold. In fact, I was just talking to the investors, and the investors feel they realize that we don't have any NPA loss as far as gold loan is concerned. There is absolutely no NPA loss. Whatever loan loss we have is just because of somebody pledging some spurious gold, or stolen ornaments being pledged, or some robbery happening in the branch. So every year we have around 25, 28. This year there is a 25 crores of loan loss. See, on a company which is making a net profit of more than 3,000 before tax, the 25 crores of loan loss is actually very, 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 very insignificant. And there has never been any loss because of NPA. So all the banks, all the lenders realize this. Now your second part is, are they passing on the reduced interest cost to us? They would like to pass it on to us, but they are a little reluctant because they would like to squeeze more money from us though. So we have seen that they are very happy to lend to us, but they would like to get little more rate. So it's always a cat and mouse game there. But generally, if you say, we get the best of rates in the market.
So going forward, is there any regulatory risk to the business? Let's say a gap in the margins, because that's what happened to even the microfinance industry a couple of years back. So do you also see any sort of such regulatory concern coming in?
So, okay, yeah, the margins, net interest margins are good. But what has happened to the microfinance with the cap, etc., has already happened to the gold loan sector 7 years, 6 years back. But actually, when gold loan business was growing very fast, RBI also did not realize what was happening, because so many new players were coming, existing players were growing. Some of them, even we were growing at a CAGR of 40 to 50% year on year for 3 or 4 years. So RBI did not realize what was happening. So they put some checks and balances and controls, and also they tried to understand the sector. Actually, there are no specific rules and regulations for gold loan sector, which has been evolved today, whether it is the LTV, the auction process, all the processes actually they are evolving. And probably RBI is also looking at Muthoot, the leading player in the market, to help get little more info on what all processes they should be doing. So all these regulatory things have all been behind us, and we feel that the regulator is comfortable with what we are doing. But finally, as a regulator, they can do anything.
But so just one
line. There is anything warranting such an action by the RBI today.
So just one last question. What is the portfolio mix you're targeting? And what is the kind of investments that you're planning for some of the new businesses that you've been focusing on?
So as I said, we have in the lending side, we have three subsidiaries. One is the home finance. Today it has a portfolio of 4,900. We would like to grow it to about 2,700, 2,800 next year. And the second one is the microfinance, which has about 2,100 crores of portfolio. We would like to grow it to about 2,900. And the third is, I forgot to tell you, is our vehicle finance business, which is called the Muthoot Money, which is presently doing business in Telangana, Andhra Pradesh. It has a 350 crores of portfolio as of date. We would like to increase that also to 850 crores. So these are the three main businesses which we are doing. We have also started personal loan in a very small way, small personal loans, 1 lakh, 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs in another business, which is about 120 crores of portfolio today, which we would like to grow to about 500 crores. All these put together, today our non-gold loan portfolio is about 12%, 88% gold loan, and non-gold loan is 12%. We wanted it to reach 15%, but we had to close it by 12%. Probably next year we should see it growing to about 15-16% of the total AUM. So 15-16 should be the non-gold loan business, and gold loan should be about the balance, 83-84%. But having said that, our first priority is for gold loan. And wherever opportunity is there for gold loan, we will 100% do it. And all the others, we will certainly be looking at it also.
All right, sir. With that, I'll wrap up this interview. Thank you so much for joining us and helping us understand your Q4 earnings.